You good? Good afternoon. Welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining us here today at Van Hoos. Today, I'm updating you on three reviews that we conducted regarding Jeffersontown High School and the incident that occurred on November 1st at J-Town High School. First, Dr. Roger Cleveland, an expert in the field, conducted a culture and climate audit at Jeffersontown High School in late October. We are including that in your information packet today. Second, Assistant Superintendent Michelle Dillard and a team of JCPS administrators reviewed systems and structures at the school. And finally, our outside counsel, Middleton Rutlinger, conducted an independent review of the November 1st incident and specifically policies and procedures in JCPS in regards to school resource officers based on national best practices and also recommendations from the Department of Education. You've been provided copies of all of those reports. First, concerning culture and climate at J-Town. The culture and climate audit found three key growth areas for improvement at Jeffersontown High School, focused on systems thinking, consistency in communication, and creating a culturally responsive learning environment. In each of those areas is much opportunity for overall improvement at the school. Simply put, results from the review tell us that across the board, discipline at J-Town High School needs consistency and improved structure. Structures are needed to create a better learning environment for all students. The school also needs significant work around a common mission and vision. We are committed here at JCPS and at J-Town High School to that work. Acting Principal Matt Anderson has been provided the report and is implementing the recommendations with the guidance of Assistant Superintendent Michelle Dillard. It's also important to note that during its review, the audit team recognized positive initiatives underway at J-Town High School that are doing quite well. For example, the school was commended for its collaborative work to make the new Freshman Academy function effectively, and also noted the school's strong industry partnerships in regards to the academies of Louisville, which are providing important real-world project-based learning opportunities for the students there. As for the review of the incident itself by our outside counsel, several areas were highlighted that we as a district should and will consider moving forward. First, it's important to understand that school resource officers, or SROs, were not directly involved in this incident. In fact, the report recognizes repeatedly Officer Steve Mattingly's professionalism and his commitment to students, and he is noted as a positive example of the SRO program. However, the report also recognizes that while law enforcement may be following their training and protocols, there may be alternative responses better suited for a school setting. The report recommends that the district draft and implement new policies and procedures that clearly outline the roles and responsibilities of police and school resource officers in the district. Examples of those recommendations in the report include that the district consider expanding an explanation of officers' responsibilities, as well as provide examples of behaviors that should not trigger law enforcement action, which follow guidelines suggested by the Department of Education. The district may consider providing examples of misdemeanors SROs may commonly encounter and suggestions on de-escalation techniques to avoid student criminal charges. The report recommends that JCPS provide further guidance on the execution of law enforcement action on campuses. JCPS ensure that SROs know what resources and processes are available for disciplinary action and what issues are meant to be handled by school staff. That the district increase training for SROs and include training for all staff at schools with SROs, clearly outlining the roles of SROs in schools. That the district develop an oversight and review process to ensure SROs are appropriately being used in schools. And finally, that the district develop a clear communication structure for contacting outside police, including schools without an SRO. Although some of this work is underway, I will immediately begin working with my staff to draft recommended policies and update our existing agreements with departments that provide our school resource officers. Finally, I do want to make sure to note the district's response to this issue. After this incident, I made clear that our plan would be to review this incident and report back our findings as quickly as possible in a public forum. That's not always the way things have worked at JCPS, and I want to commend everybody on my team making sure that we moved quickly to address situations and issues at Jeffersontown High School and work to improve our systems with school resource officers. I want our students, parents, and staff to know that this issue was addressed immediately and recommendations will be implemented. At the end of the day, I believe the recommendations will provide a more positive learning environment for our schools, staff, and students moving forward and provide for safe school environments, which I believe is the most important part of our work. I'll now be happy to answer any questions that you might have. Mandy. Yes, I believe that issue is in the report, but there were some outside incidents outside of the school in the neighborhood on the weekend before, which the SRO asked for additional resources in the school, additional police officers, which is one of the recommendations on providing clear communication and systems through the district about how we bring in outside police officers and who would be responsible for that. So that is one of the recommendations that we are going to work on quickly as we move forward.
Do you see SROs as having a strong role in the future at JCPS? Do you feel they're crucial to have?
As I've said many times, I believe SROs can be very effective in supporting safe schools. Just like anything else, it requires quality, strong SROs. I've had the opportunity to work with three fantastic educators that are SROs. But I also believe that, as with anything in an effective organization, systems are so important, systems and structures. And clearly, I think we have now seen through these reports and investigations that we have some systems lacking when it comes to consistency, across all of the organizations that supply us with SROs, training, communication, and several other areas that you'll find in the report. So, yes, they can be very effective, but it is important for us to make sure that there is consistency, oversight, and evaluation of anyone who is in our schools.
Do you think more training is needed for officers that maybe aren't SROs? I know SROs receive additional training. Do you think
the report talks about that in the investigative report, and I want to once again remind you this is the report from the investigators. And so they do talk about a much more collaborative relationship with our departments that are providing SROs and potentially non-SROs, even for schools, as I said, who don't have an SRO, so that when we know that if police activity or action is needed at a school, that there has been the appropriate training and response for students.
How much feedback have you gotten from police generally and Jefferson Town Police specifically in light of this report?
We've had several meetings with Jefferson Town Police, but the investigation included the investigator met with Officer Mattingly at J-Town Police Department, so I think he was an important part of that. So there has been that conversation. Obviously, as is well documented, also a lot of community conversation, folks speaking at the board, and clearly it's an issue that is very divided amongst our community. In between the time of this incident and today when I'm providing this report, we have met with all of our partners, all of our police department agency partners, and they all are very willing to work with us just as we do. They want what's best for the community and students. So yes, they're willing to work with us. Yes. Yes, we will be updating all of them to include additional training for our SROs.
Thank you.
school, we're a J-Town volunteer, asked for voluntary demotion. Do you expect any personnel changes in light of this? We might be, I guess, reinstated principal or what?
No, the principal selection process is currently underway at Jeffersontown High School. The site-based council has, I believe, set out a timeline. Michelle Dillard is leading that process, and we expect to name a permanent principal in the first 2 weeks of February.
Last question, please.
Is that a question? Okay.
Obviously, a lot of the controversy surrounding this has been calls from the community to remove all police from schools. It will have a lot to do with race, and folks out there saying that this would have happened if these kids hadn't been African-American. So I guess within what you got back from the report and moving forward, will the district be taking into account issues of disproportionate consequences applied across students' races?
I think we have to take data around disproportionality in everything that we do, because we have some disproportionate data. So whether it's arrest or suspensions or the achievement gap, we have data that concerns us that we have to address. And so that's not to put the blame on any one person or group, but systemically as an organization and as a community. I've made it very clear that I believe that this community being successful and the future of our community being successful is going to require all of our community working together to improve the outcomes for students and all students. And so that's why I believe the power of initiatives like Louisville Promise Partnership and other ways where we explore working together as a community is so important. And I think that's where we're headed, but without a doubt, disproportionality has to be a concern in everything that we do, and most importantly, outcomes around the achievement gap.
Thank you.
Happy holidays. Hope you have a more boring 2018 than 2017.